Continuing their journey by gypsy caravan along the old pilgrim's way between Winchester and Canterbury, this week playwright Peter Terson and travelling companion Dennis Skillicorn start at Seal, pass through Compton, skirt Guildford to the south, and carry on to Albury and beyond.
Outfit, isn't it,
compared with us?
Yeah.
Say hello to him.
Morning.
Good morning. What's all this, then?
Well, we're on the road. We're going to Canterbury.
Yeah?
Yeah. We need a heavy outfit, you know, as you can imagine, to get there and sleep in and on, so on. Not like yours. This is a spanking outfit, isn't it?
Pretty, isn't she?
Oh, she's lovely. Yeah. Do you train her to get her knees up and look tidy and all that?
No. That's spread into them.
Is it?
Yes.
That's a very light harness. She doesn't even have a collar.
No, that's styled on the American breast collar harness. Americans never use the collar harness like you've got on your horse. And many of them.
Is that because it's a very light load?
That's it. A little light trap, rally car.
Yeah. 1903. Mm-hmm. She has the breech, and like mine, on a smaller scale, doesn't she?
No brakes.
Oh. What's this bit round the tail?
The cropper.
The cropper, yeah. That's, we don't have one because we've got the heavier breeching and the pad.
Yeah?
Hey, it's a lovely outfit. How many coats of paint on this?
Quite a few, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
very expensive, you know, to keep them up like this.
Is it?
Yeah. Mm. Not many people know how to do it today.
Mm. Do you go rallying in it?
Go to shows, yeah. Mm. Local shows, and marathons.
At what distance?
Last Sunday we went about 24 miles.
Mm. I see the tugs are just hooked on and that's protected, a bit of weather.
Is that? Well, it's a light vehicle, isn't it? I mean, it's different to yours. You've got chains and things like that.
Oh, I'm amazed that takes the strength.
Oh, it does. Mm. Yeah. Well, you see, it's all double stitched.
Yes, of course it is. You fancy joining us for a cup of tea?
Thank you very much.
Oh, good.
I'd love one.
Oh, good.
Thank you.
Take the stool. My man will hold the horse. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I'll appreciate it. This is.
If this is the stockbroker belt, it must say something for the good taste of stockbrokers, at least in choosing where to live. A medieval pilgrim transplanted into this 20th century scene would suffer the minimum of culture shock, except perhaps over the white line in the middle of the road. In Putnam itself, the time traveller would notice a few changes. But there must have been somewhere even then where pilgrims could get their groceries. There's a reminder of journeys and times long past in the sign over Putnam's village shop.
Oh, my. Well, boy, that'll do it. That'll do it. Right, Dennis, I think we better stock up.
Shopping time. I'll go and do the shopping, if you like.
OK, do you know what we need?
Yep.
Everything.
Right.
Have you any money?
Yes.
Makes a change.
We didn't have anything left, did we? It's quite amusing, that.
Is it not licensed?
No, I don't think it's licensed, no. Right. You look after the horses and I'll go and do the business.
Right.
You'll probably have to give me a hand to carry it out later.
Good morning.
Morning.
What can I do for you then, sir?
Oh, I've been told to get everything.
Well, we haven't got everything, sir, but we've got plenty of bread, sir.
Bread is a must, sir.
We've got a few tins here, tins of beans, spaghetti. Goodbye, sir, and safe journey.
Thank you.
Cheerio.
They were glad we called.
Right, I'll stack this in the back.
Can we live?
Yes, nice and secure.
Was it licensed?
No license, sorry. Are we off?
Yep.
Off come on, Tobe. Let's go. Lead the way, lad.
Just follow with Toby. Or are you going to
come
lead?
On, Toby.
Good lad.
Oh, I'll get something for him
okay,
as well.
OK, Marcus. We've got yours in. Good lad.
A bit dodgy down here because of all the cars parked, isn't it?
Puttenham isn't exactly the back of beyond, but it can seem that way when heading down a sandy track with no idea what the access is like for gypsy caravans.
Right.
Good to be off the main road, isn't it?
Yes, it is, Dennis, but these obstacles we have to watch, otherwise we'll have no canvas left.
That's right, the overhead ones, that was the difficulty,
boy,
wasn't it?
Yeah. Dennis, here, take the horse, I'll take the branch.
All right.
Come on, then.
Come on, then. Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Go on, then. Walk on, Dennis.
All right, go on. Walk on. Walk on. Walk on. Come on.
Well, this is the way, Dennis. This is the way. Can we make it? Oh, boy. I think this is it, Dennis.
Is it? What, Pilgrim's Way?
The very one. Is this the Pilgrim's Way?
Yes, Pilgrim's Way, yes.
Can we get through with this?
No, you won't get through.
Oh, dear.
No braves.
Ah. We can't get through, Dennis.
Go this way.
Ah. That means we've missed the Pilgrim's Way.
Well, I don't know. Look, I think, just for the sake of it, I think I'll go through on my bike. Would I get through on a bike?
Yeah, you get through on a bike, yes. Quite easy.
How far is it?
Mile and a half.
Oh, I'll meet you at the other side, then.
OK, then. As long as one blazes the trail.
Good.
Yes, right, sure. Thanks. Yeah. That's good. And I can get out this way
you
easy, can I?
This way, yeah.
OK, then, Marcus. Oh, get your bike off, Dennis. Yeah, get your bike off.
Yeah.
Thanks very much.
Yeah.
I'll see you in a while.
Good. The pioneer strikes out. Okay. Good lad.
Though serviceable, Dennis's bike is only the very distant cousin of a racing model. So, for that matter, is Marcus.
Where have you been?
There you are. It's a good job I saw the smoke. I'd never have found you, Peter.
Oh, would you not?
Now, where have you been?
Well, I just found this place, so I pulled in.
Ah, simple. I don't blame you. I got lost.
Did you?
Yeah. I'm exhausted. Absolutely exhausted.
All these protestations of fatigue clearly leave Peter quite unmoved, because he's about to give Dennis the stiffest test of the journey so far. But first, a check that horse transport hasn't damaged yesterday's acquisition from the studio of Deborah Fladgate at Seal.
That's beautiful, isn't it?
The best plate we could wish for, that. Now, Dennis, please. No breakages. That's
cotton
precious.
Wool job, I think.
Oh, absolutely. Now, I tell you what, your big test. See if we can harness that horse on your own. I shan't help at all.
OK, I'll give you a shout if I need it.
Right, OK.
Right. Come on, boy. Steady, boy. Steady. Steady, lad. Steady, lad. Belly strap. You're going to be surprised when you see this.
Don't rush or you'll make the horse excited.
Oh, yeah. Do you think I'll get crushed to death?
I think something's happening.
Oh! I can adjust the tension on this later, can't I?
It's enough to try the patience of a saint, never mind a pilgrim. But generations of selective breeding have ensured that Marcus can put up with almost anything. Generations of donkey breeding have taught Toby that if people are careless about where they leave their lunch, that's their lookout.
Well, this is the tricky bit, isn't it?
Yes.
Come on, boy.
You haven't forgotten anything, have you?
No. Come on,
lad.
Open your mouth, lad. Put your head down.
Get the bit well in its teeth.
Yeah, come on in. Open you go. There you go, good lad.
Careful of its ears, now. You've got to put them through nicely, otherwise they'll get hurt.
There we go.
Hey, that's excellent, Dennis.
I wouldn't start praising yet.
Should we do without putting the collar on?
Oh, dear me. Yeah, all right. OK.
Right, yes. Good lad, I forgot about that. Should have gone on first, shouldn't
we? Oh, we go. That's the idea. That's the idea. Steady, steady, steady. Steady, then.
Back pad connected to the collar.
That's a good idea. That's a brilliant idea. I'll adjust it later, you see, Peter.
Yes, yes.
Much later.
Man shall not live by bread alone. Not today, anyway.
Navigation among canal people.
W-E-Y.
Yep.
Come on then. Come on, Marcus. Over you go.
It's the navigation down the Weybridge.
Yeah.
I used to be a canal man.
Soon over the top.
I used to be a canal man.
You did?
Yep.
You've done a bit, eh? Come on, Marcus.
Turn right over the North Downs, and that's a lovely run, they say. I mean, I haven't been. Have you seen it?
No, I haven't. But it's lovely to just get off the main road and be on a track. You'll find that the animals love it. The horse will pull well, and Toby will feel better, just to feel natural earth underneath it.
Yeah, it's so much better, isn't it, to get away from the fumes of the exhaust.
And, the road, and the slidey road.
You don't have to keep pulling over.
No, they'll go. It's marvellous. They'll go over anything. Marcus will pull over anything on a natural side.
I shall probably feel like a pilgrim again, because I felt like a pilgrim on my bike, you see.
Well, you can cycle that bit.
Is that the pilgrim's way? That's it. North Downs Way.
Oh, great.
The pilgrim's way, yes. Sir.
Great.
So we're going to go along here, and we're heading for Albury, I think, aren't we?
Excellent. That'll be great to get off the main road all that time. Traffic, isn't it?
Lovely, isn't it? Yeah.
We are now on the Pilgrim's Way. Official.
And so near to the town, it's lovely, isn't it?
Do you feel any sense of the spiritual journey yet?
Well, I dare say if I tried hard, I could see them there walking up the road, disappear, or perhaps with donkeys.
Yeah, yeah, donkeys.
Horses even.
Yeah. They'd be better with donkeys than we were, I suppose, wouldn't they?
They know more about them, I should think. Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, if we go a long way like this, we could. This is the way, instead of towing them, this is the way, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, as long as he pulls along with you, yes, that's amazing. I've learned a lot about donkeys this year.
Hey, come on, Toby, I'm getting caught here.
But it gives the horse a good grip, doesn't it?
Yes, it does, it does.
I noticed our shoes seem to slip.
I bet those tyres are heavy in the sand, though. My goodness. Old Toby likes it better.
Yeah, there's a lot of dust, too. No wonder the cowboys used to wear neckerchiefs.
My goodness, isn't it?
That's a good idea. I must buy a neckerchief, perhaps.
Yeah.
Perhaps I won't bother.
Oh, that's better.
I tell you what, it keeps you fit, doesn't it? Got to keep my eye on what's going on behind your plate. Is your plate all right?
The glass plate.
Is that all right? All right, steady on, then. Do you feel a lot fitter, Peter?
A lot slimmer, funnily enough.
Oh, I feel fit myself.
Lost pounds, do you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's always the activity, isn't it? It's the complete activity from morning till night.
Yeah. You learn not to worry about what's going on behind, because you know it'll be all right.
Yes.
Ooh. It'll be all right on the night.
It's amazing how well the caravan has sprung, isn't it, with all this roughness.
Yeah, how old is the chassis?
It's about 1920, a London trolley. Watch these, Dennis. Push them over this way.
Yeah, one in, over there. Over there.
That's good.
Because that chimney could come off, couldn't it, easily enough?
Easy, easy.
And that would give us a problem. Steady back.
Hey, look at the road ahead, isn't it?
Steady, what a lovely road.
As the travellers make their way nonchalantly through luscious Surrey, only the glimpse of houses on the brow of the hill hints at the presence of Guildford, less than a mile away.
Ah, oh, that's very kind of you.
Go on then, you put it down, I'll reach for it.
Back to it. There you are. What's the Toby's got in here?
Marcus only does about 3 miles to the gallon in hot weather, so that pause for refueling should see him through to the other side of Albury.
Hey, look at those chimneys, Peter.
Classic, aren't they? I know all about them.
Do you?
I was told in the pub.
Go on. Tell me a bit more.
Built by the architect Fusion, a man of French extraction.
Yeah.
He built the House of Commons. And they
Did
were
he?
Built for the Lord of the Manor here, Henry, who's the grandfather of the present Duke of Northumberland. Dennis, big hill ahead. I think it's the roller job.
Okay, roller it is, sir.
You know how to do it?
Of course.
I'll hold the horse, otherwise your fingers might get jammed.
I've watched the master many times.
Dennis, make sure the chain is hanging nicely on the inside.
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay. I think we'd better bring the donkey up ahead as well, Dennis.
Okay.
And then Marcus will follow him.
All right, come on, Tobe. Round the front. Come on, lad. Big walk up.
Come on in.
Come on.
Oh, boy, not yet. There he comes. Here he comes. Look at that. He wants to go already.
Yeah. Come on, Tobe.
Marcus, that. You've got to... Cruel smirk on your face.
A cruel smirk.
I think we're reaching the point of another move here, Dennis.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. I think we'll have to do something.
Yeah, I think we can't drive him up here. It's too hard. Whoa, Dennis. Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa. Now, we're literally stuck, kid. We can't get any further than this.
So it'll rest on the roller while we decide what to do?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Well, I think the best way is to go to a farmer, say, ask him if he has a tractor or something, and pull us up.
Pull us up.
Otherwise, it means staying all night here. How's that?
That's fine, yeah.
Fine. Oh, boy. Oh.
Okay,
you'll
then?
Take the strain very, very slowly, won't you?
Okay.
Thanks a lot, now. Walk on, boy. Yeah, go on, Howard.
It may be a little ignominious to have to fall back on the internal combustion engine, but Marcus isn't proud. Not when the alternative is a solo effort from him, requiring rather more than he feels like contributing towards the end of a long day.
No. Splendid, lovely job. Thank you very much.
Come on in, Tobe.
Nearly there, Toby. If you haven't got a Land Rover, you've got me to pull you up. Come on, mate.
Like banks and multiple stores, these Surrey lanes have branches everywhere. It's not that our travellers are vandals. They yield to no one in their passion for tree conservation. But when there's no way forward without some skillful pruning, they've little choice.
Steady on. Steady on. Okay.
Does that make it clear now?
Yes, that's okay. Come on, then. Come on, Tom. Come on, boy. You can do it. Good lad. Come on, then. Keep it moving. That's a good lad. Up we go. That's the idea. Nearly there, lad. Nearly there, boy. Come on. Come on, then. That's a good lad. Keep it going. There's a good lad.
There's an old saw among gypsy caravanners that you should always carry an old saw. With luck, that's the last time it'll be needed.
Okay.
And so it's off once again to see what the future holds on the Pilgrim's Way.
In the journey next week, Peter, Dennis, Marcus and Toby continue their journey across Surrey, where they encounter problems on the hills.
Now listen, this is the tricky bit. Yeah. If anything goes wrong, I'm going to run onto that grass verge and the drag shoe will go into the muck and all that, you know.
Yeah, and then we'll stop.
Stay on this side of me, and if I shout anything, get the brake on pretty sharpish.
Right then.
It rains for the first time.
It's great because you don't have to worry, it doesn't matter what time it is. If you can't go any further, you have to rest.
That's right, yeah.
Oh, we'd never make it.
But they press on to the top of Box Hill.
Great view, isn't it?
There it is. Box Hill.
Eventually, they reach Outwood Mill, where they camp for the night.
Have a jug.
That's the journey next Tuesday at 10:15 here on BBC One in the South.